Story time, my toxic best friend outed me to the entire school. So one day, one of my best friends from a neighboring school decided to move to my school, and she was extremely upset because her best friend over there came out as bi. So I ended up using this as an opportunity to come out bi as well. And she was like, well, it's okay for you. I just got really close to her. We'll call the girl Becky because no one likes a Becky, and we can call her friend Heather. So fast forward to after the situation had calmed down, we decided to all go prom dress shopping. So Heather and I were talking and we really hit it off. And I think Becky legitimately forgot about our sexuality because we were all talking about how much we have in common and we brought that up as well. She just looked at us and was like, oh, I forgot about that. And she just shrugged it off. But we continued to hang out for a few weeks. One of these weekends, we all went to church together and the sermon was about how God accepts you no matter what your sexuality is. But of course, Becky turns around to us and says that Heather and I could never date because it would F everything up. Later that day, Heather actually ended up admitting that she had feelings for me, and this is when Becky lost it. Stay tuned for part two and follow part two of my toxic best friend outing me to the entire school. So at the beach later that day, Heather and I decided to tell Becky how we felt. She freaked and wouldn't talk to us and locked herself in the bathroom. And we had to tell her that it's fine, we won't date, just so she would let herself out. I thought she was being entirely selfish, not wanting her best friends to be happy. And then she literally took my phone and went through all of our texts together. She woke up the next day, all ready for Heather and I to be together and completely apologized. And then when we went to the mall that day, she walked away from us to go look at the hot guys, but then turned around and got pissed at us for falling behind. And this is why she said she didn't want us to date, yet we weren't even dating. She said she felt like she was gonna have to choose between Heather and I because of the whole situation, and I guess she just picked me. Becky became extremely codependent and didn't want to leave my side. She was pissed if I spent time with anyone else and basically forced Heather out of my life. I ended up running into Heather and inviting her to my 18th birthday, and this is when Becky had her massive breakdown. At my birthday, she outed me to everyone at the party, my mom, and Heather's mom as well. My Insta is linked below for more
content. The teacher had a crush on me? Story time. When I was in 9th grade, I had a really creepy history teacher. And by creepy, I mean he used to be really handsy. Whenever I had his class throughout the whole period, he would randomly come up to me and start massaging my neck or rub on my lower back. But the creepiest thing he did is whenever I asked him a question, he would sit next to me and place his hand on my inner thigh area. Mind you guys, that he was in his 50s and I was only 14 at the time. So the day I found out he had a crush on me was actually Valentine's Day. During homeroom, everyone was receiving candygrams, which was a lollipop and a note attached to it. So I received one, and when I looked at the note, it was from my history teacher. And it said, I know you're not 18 yet, but you should still hit me up anyway. And then he put his number in the note. Ugh. So of course I had to report him, and he got in a lot of trouble. I had the creepiest dream. Story time. So last night, I had this dream that I was in this daycare with this creepy little boy. And the thing that made him creepy is that I think he was dead. His eyes and mouth were sewn shut, but he was still able to talk to me and see me. It was weird. He was also covered in dirt like somebody just dug him out of a grave. So he starts showing me around the daycare and he leads me to the main office. Inside the main office, there was nothing but this huge glass container, and inside of the container were these glowing orbs. And I asked the boy what they were, and he told me that they were souls of people who got stuck. And in that moment, I started to realize that I was in a dream. So then I asked him, like, am I dreaming right now? And he turns to me, rips his eyes open, rips his mouth open, and he says, if they realize that you're awake, you will be stuck here too. And then he takes his hand, puts it over my eyes, and I wake up from my dream.
Story of the time a cop went in my car without my permission. So for a while, I was going to people's houses to do their nails. And I would do this in the summer, so a lot of my clients set up a table outside so that the smell didn't smell up their house too bad. I always feel rude to park in the person's driveway, so I usually park outside of their house on the side of the road. And this time in particular, I did just that, and we did her nails outside as well. At the time, my car had templates on it because I had just recently got it. And also, my car is a BMW two-door with all tinted windows, so you cannot see inside of it, even if you tried. So I could understand why it looks a little bit suspicious. Luckily for me, my nail client's dog ended up running out of the fence into the front yard, right near my car. So I go with her to chase him, and I see the police officer opening up my car door. And I wasn't parked illegally or anything, and my templates weren't expired either. So he had no right to be opening up my car doors. So I ran over to my car and I was like, what's going on? Why are you searching my car? And he was like, this is your car? part two to a cop searching my car without my permission. So I see this police officer opening up my car door and putting his head inside my car. So I'm like, excuse me, officer, is there an issue? Why are you searching my car? And he was like, oh, like, this is your car? And I was like, yes, do you have a warrant? And then he said, do you live here? And I was like, no, but do you have a warrant? And then he said, no, actually, the neighbor called me because he was concerned, and I actually live down the street, and the car was unfamiliar, so I felt the need to search it. I can't see inside of your car because of the tint, so I didn't know if somebody was in there, like maybe sleeping in their car or something. I don't really remember what he said, but I was like, okay, but I think you need a warrant to search the car. Please close my door. And honestly, he was pretty nice about it, I'm not gonna lie. I was just really annoyed because in my head, I'm thinking like, why? Like, I'm not doing anything wrong. I'm always getting caught up for doing nothing.
My sister and I have always been mistaken as twins. I'm 19 and she's 16, but we have the same height, skin tone, and similar voice. She also has a habit of being a copycat, from the way I dress to hobbies, even piercings. I know it's cute if you look at it from the outside, but sometimes it gets annoying. Like, yeah, we are quite close too, but why does she always happen to pick up everything I pick up? One afternoon, I was tidying up some costumes in my college showroom and found a rather cute brown and pink wig. It looks like a mushroom. I put it on, think it looks rather funny, so I snapped a picture and posted it to my Instagram. I received a text from my sister asking if I really cut my hair. I didn't mention it was a wig. While I somewhat have a feeling that she might copy that too, I lied and replied, yes. I came home that weekend, and lo and behold, my sister emerged with the same silly brown and pink bob cut, except this one is on her permanent hair. She was surprised that I arrived with my hair so long, then realized that I lied to her. She was furious that she had to cut that silly hairstyle because she thought I had it. Our parents think that it's a really bad joke and wanted me to cut my hair too to make it up to her.
So am I the asshole for telling my sister I cut my hair when I really didn't?
Story time about my boyfriend cheating on me with his stepsister and other women. So once I was allowed to have Snapchat and logged into his account, I saw him messaging multiple other girls, including his stepsister. And when I tell you guys I scrolled up on these messages and found out that he had been sleeping with her too, this had been going on for 2.5 years before he finally called things off with me and broke up with me. We met up to exchange things and I gave him all of his stuff back, but he didn't give me any of my stuff back because he forgot. And he tried to give me his own stuff back, saying that we were on a break and would get back together. Because I called things off with him, he ended up throwing all of my stuff, like my clothes, jewelry, Beats headphones, in a fire pit and burned them, as if he was the victim. Like, what did I do to you? You were the one sleeping with your stepsister our entire relationship. After about 3 months, he showed up with a new girlfriend on his Instagram. And she ended up messaging me asking why he still had pictures of me all over his room and why my necklace with my name on it was hanging in his truck.
Am I the asshole for making my germaphobe husband change our baby's diaper? My husband and I have a 2-month-old together. He does everything almost except changing diapers. He's a hardcore germaphobe, so I handle the dirty part of our son's care. So my husband's been pestering me about the faces I make when changing our son's diapers, telling me to smile all the time. I told him to leave me alone, and it's easy for him to say when he's not the one dealing with the smell. But every time I'm in the middle of changing diapers, my husband would show up out of nowhere like he busted me or something and tell me that the faces I keep making have an impact on our son's emotional state and I should smile. I told him to leave me alone. He knows how difficult this is for me, but does nothing to help. Instead, just mocks me and keeps pestering me. I said if he ever tries to hassle me again with just smile bullcrap, then he'll start handling the diaper changes himself. Last night around 9, he was in the kitchen already eating dinner without me and not waiting while I was getting ready to change my son's diaper. He came into the room with his mouth full of food and once again commented on how my face looked and for me to smile and show love and to stop causing harm to our son's emotional health. I snapped.